Hey guys, Mark Hall here. We're talking about student ministry, youth worker to youth worker here. We talked our last little segment about the fact that our walk with God is the lid on our student ministry because number one, it guards my heart. It keeps things like fear and doubt and worry and envy and all those things that can creep into a minister's head. It keeps that stuff at bay and it keeps our mind on God, but it also changes the way we see people, right? So we see them like Jesus sees them. But one of the things you'll start seeing is when you start seeing your students like God sees them, you're going to start loving them. And that's going to transform everything you do. If what motivates us to be in student ministry is a platform or a purpose, we have this great need for a purpose and to be needed, so we're pouring into people, that's really not the right motivation, right? So when I'm walking with Jesus, what I will see is He completes me, not ministry. Not people loving me and adoring me or any of that kind of stuff, because they won't always do that, really. But when I'm walking with God, what happens is, man, He's filling me up, so when I get to the people, all I got to do is love them. That takes us to our second point, relationship. I don't know if you know this, but teenagers are starting to figure out. All the adults in their life, most of them are paid to be there or required by law to be there, right? So they're starting to realize that the things that people are saying is kind of their job to say that. So what will blow the mind of a young person is for a grown-up to actually want to hang out with them. Not just to teach a lesson at them, not just to sing at them or to make them be still and sit in their seats. But when a teenager discovers an adult that knows their name and that knows that their parents are divorced and that knows that they've had the cruddiest year of their life, they just got cut from this, they just got broke up with, they've just failed this. Man, when they meet an adult who knows those things and who checks up on them and who asks them about their lives, what you've just done is you've just earned the right to pour the truth into them that you've been trying to pour in with these 30-minute lessons a week. But you can't walk into a student's life, you can't walk into a person's life and stand up on stage and talk for 45 minutes and leave. It's not going to work. What that will do is get some truth in their head. There's some great things that can happen that way. But man, if you're going to build a disciple, disciples are built knees to knees, life on life. What we've got to do is pour into them and love them. And once we love them, we've earned the right to pour truth into them. We tracking? So it's really not you being cooler. It's really not you getting a new haircut and being more athletic so the jocks will like you and all that kind of stuff. That's just breaking the ice stuff, okay? Jocks may gravitate to jocks and glamour girls may gravitate to glamour girls, but that doesn't build disciples. What builds disciples is people who love them. That's what it all starts with. So if I'm not guarding my time with Jesus like we talked about last time, I'm not going to love them like that. I'm going to be motivated in little spurts to do that, but I'm not going to carry it out. Guard your time with Jesus, see Him like He does. Then you can love them like He does and earn the right to pour truth into them.